Welcome to 7 Grand and happy holidays. My name is Chad Owen, lead bartender here at 7 Grand. The holiday season sets us up to drink quite a few delicious cocktails. In this case, I'm particularly focused on the notorious eggnog, and the store-bought is pretty, well, I just prefer to make it from scratch. It's a bit involved, and it's a little bit more like cooking and a little less like mixing drinks. So I'm gonna walk you through all the ingredients first and then talk about the process and show you each thing step by step. So beginning, we're gonna do 12 egg yolks and 3/4 cup of sugar. Those are gonna have to get beaten and put together. I'll show you how to do that. We're gonna need about 16 ounces of Wild Turkey 81 bourbon. You're welcome to use any spirit you want. I think whiskey and especially the Wild Turkey work really well in this just because of the really nice spice backbone that they're gonna have. You're gonna need a 1/2 pint of heavy cream and 2 pints of whole milk and a dozen egg whites whipped to soft peaks, as you can see. And an entire nutmeg grated down. Absolutely do this fresh. It's gonna make the nutmeg much more nutmeggy, and you're gonna be in really good shape there. So we'll walk through the process step by step now. Some pieces have been moved away. We're gonna start with our egg yolks, and we're gonna beat these until they've increased in volume by about 2/3, and it's gonna go kind of white and creamy on us. You can do this with an immersion blender. I prefer it by hand just because there's a sense of machismo that my dad put into me when I was a kid regarding cooking. As you can see, now that they're good and whipped, the texture has increased to a much more golden yellow color, and you've got a nice kind of stringy texture coming out of the egg yolks. So we're gonna keep whipping, not quite as intense, and add our 3/4 cup of sugar. I'm using superfine in this case, but it's not all that critical. You just gotta beat a little bit harder, a little bit faster, if you're gonna use just standard table sugar. Incorporate it slowly. You gotta do this step very, very slowly, otherwise there's a big series of chemistry mumbo jumbo conversations that we could have, and I'll spare you that, but do it slowly. It should be a very almost sticky in feeling kind of texture. And this is kind of exactly what we want. It's just pulling ribbons. So the next step now is we're going to gradually incorporate the alcohol. Again, continuously whipping. Not actually going to measure this. I'm gonna do more of an eyeball. It's 16 ounces, so I think I can get pretty close without causing too much trouble. And the alcohol doesn't add any specific texture or consistency that we need to be concerned about in this situation. So just kind of add it till you're almost there. Add a little bit more than I wanted in the bottle, so spare it there. Now we have our alcohol and our egg yolks. We're in good shape. And at this point, we're going to move everything into the punch bowl. I have the egg whites set aside and start with our heavy cream. And we're just gonna go straight into the punch bowl. And as all the steps in this process, continual mixing as you pour. Just everything has to get really well incorporated. It's just an extensive process you gotta take care of. And we're gonna add our whole milk, do 1 pint at a time, stirring the whole time. There is a conversation to be had about whether you whip the heavy cream first. It's up to you, figure out what you like. At this point, we have all of these pieces incorporated. I like to add the nutmeg now. I feel like I can get it better incorporated into the punch before we fold in the egg whites, which is kind of the last crucial step to making this punch something light, airy, and delicious instead of really heavy, intense, and nauseating. In the egg whites go. Nice, gentle fold. Don't overmix this because you don't want to break down all of the nice texture that you got out of the egg whites to begin with. For those of you that are concerned about the eggs being consumed without being cooked, the alcohol in our step when we add it with the egg yolks is actually going to contribute to a little bit of sterilization and a touch of cooking of the egg. So the last final steps of our eggnog, this is made, it's prepared, it's ready to go. I like to do a final scraping of nutmeg over the top just because it looks pretty, but it only lasts about 5 minutes at any party anyway, so it's not that big of a deal. And then we are just going to serve our eggnog. Nice thick texture, but actually quite light and airy. Gentle dusting over the top. Cheers and happy holidays from 7 Grand. Since we don't ever want to put anything to waste here, we're probably gonna serve this tonight. And eggnog's really cool because it'll keep for a few days, and there's actually more than a few recipes that tell you to let it set before you actually serve it. I don't find that actually necessary, but it definitely will keep for at least a week if you put it in an airtight container in your refrigerator, which is pretty nice because it's a lot of work. So you can do it the day beforehand